Hello.
Hi, good morning, Steve. I'm Manoj.
Hi, good morning.
Hi. So, can we start our interview session?
Yes, if you want to.
Yeah, I read about your success story and how you left job from UN and to come back to India for the rural empowerment of Indian rural society. So, it would be great to read about you. You are seriously, you are doing very good job for India and rural India basically. So first question my to you, ki how did you start this business basically?
No, I mean even as a kid, I used to be always proud of this country because of the wealth, amount of jewels the kings wore and the amount of things that were abundance was there. We did not see anybody thieving and begging and all that.
Oh.
So I knew we were a very rich country and very flourishing country, and the kings were very magnanimous. This is my background. I love the king's life and all that.
Okay.
I like the way he took care of everybody. He fought for everybody. He gave. Every day he gave dharma and all these things.
Okay.
But then for me to understand that we have gone so poor that we are begging around, you know.
Yeah.
Then I used to think, why did all these Mongols and these hordes of British, French, Dutch, Chinese, Alexander, everybody come to India? Because you must have had a lot of wealth.
Yes, of course we have.
And wealth is not created only through ancestors. It is also work, effort and the resource of the country.
Oh.
I was wondering, where did it go wrong? Where did we go wrong? Somewhere in administration, somewhere in protection, somewhere in giving, we have gone massively wrong.
Yes.
Then I said, let me go back to my... I, by chance, I went abroad, I did my education there.
Yes.
Then I had the opportunity to work for UNICEF. Then at one point of time, I said, what am I doing? Working for all other countries, sitting here?
Yes.
Let me go back to my country. So promptly, I came back. When I came back,
yes,
to understand the country, I knew I could do something.
Yeah.
When I came, I had the opportunity to buy one of the pan-India companies with large employee base.
Oh.
I worked very hard and turned around that company.
Yes.
Now I was in a position to understand. That gave me an opportunity to travel remote rural areas.
Yes.
I understood our problem is not money.
Yes.
Our problem is equal distribution.
Oh.
Okay. It is not money. It is equal distribution. Wealth is not shared with everybody. Wealth is not equally distributed. I found this lack of opportunities for the rural people and abundance in urban area.
Okay.
And second point, we knew 70% of our India is rural.
Yes.
And three, we say they are the backbone, but every day we are breaking their backbone.
Yes, of course. We are
today, there are people in India who don't have to think about what they have to spend. Money is just pouring. They can do anything as well as they have time. And here are people who are hanging themselves and dying. So, the equal opportunity was my concern. My concern was not poverty in India. My concern was equal opportunity between urban and rural area.
Yes.
So, then I said, let me do this. Then after my observation is over, I said, let me be a social entrepreneur.
Yeah, of course, social. You're doing social entrepreneur as well as you are empowering rural India, basically.
The message I would like to give out to the youth of India for becoming a successful entrepreneur is that first of all you need to have that desire of becoming a successful entrepreneur, because if you won't have that desire you cannot achieve it. So, and secondly, being an entrepreneur, it's all about taking risks. So you should love to take risks. And you don't have to, become successful by taking shortcuts. All you have to do is you have to take risks. and you have to take very small steps. Once you know your goals, you should go achieve that. You should act upon it, and this is the only way you can become a successful entrepreneur. Just go with the flow. I wish you all the best.
Here we are at Santosh Mary Ghost with the CEO, MD of this shop, Mr. Bablu. He has started this company in 2002 and he has grown it to up to 3 stores here in Ghaziabad. Now, here are a few questions to him. Hello sir, welcome to this interview. How did you get the idea or the concept for this business? How did you get the idea? This
idea
came
from my father. उन्होंने मुझसे बोला था कि जब मैं टेंथ में था तो क्योंकि हमें ये काम करना है तो उसके बाद ट्वेल्थ किया उसके बाद में हमने 3 साल एक जगह शॉप थी असम चौक दिल्ली वहाँ प्रैक्टिस की और उसी शॉप को हायर किया 1 ईयर के लिए लेकिन उनको वहाँ थोड़ा सा हमने एक्स्ट्रा काम किया तो सेल वहाँ बढ़ी और उन लोगों ने वापस उसको ले लिया उसी टाइम ये सोचा कि हम अपना ये काम अपनी शॉप लेके ही करेंगे इस चीज़ और उसके बाद हमने 2003 में यहाँ दूसरी शॉप ली और उसके बाद अपने काम शुरू किया
सर व्हाट आर द चैलेंजेस मतलब यू टोल्ड अस दैट समटाइम्स कुछ ऐसा होता है कि चीज़ें बंद हो जाती हैं सर उसके बारे में बताएं आपने कैसे अपने आप को संभाला उस समय में कैसे उसको एक मोटिवेशन बनाया
उस टाइम हम 3 या 4 साल का एक्सपीरियंस हो चुका था पता लग गया था रास्ते क्या क्या हैं उसके जाने के तो वो चीज़ तो अपने अंदर ही थी वो बस ये था कि अरेंजमेंट कैसे कैसे होगा वो सब फायदा मैंने अरेंजमेंट किया उसके लिए
बस थैंक यू फॉर दिस इंटरव्यू